गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 2, दैट इज रोमन न्यूमरल्स। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस चैप्टर लेट्स टॉक अबाउट फ्यू थिंग्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टेल मी व्हिच नंबर्स वी आर यूजिंग सिंबल्स, वी आर यूजिंग कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ सिंबल्स एंड दीज सिंबल्स आर नोन एज डिजिट्स। एंड यू नो वी हैव टोटल 10 डिजिट्स 0 to 9, so we have total 10 digits 0 to 9. These digits are known as symbols. Now what is number? Number is single digit or a combination of digits. Like if I am writing 47, this is a number. Why this is a number? Because this is a combination of two digit, that is 4 and 7. So these number 47, 89, 84 and so on, these all are numbers. These numbers are according to international numerals. These numbers are known as international numerals, or they can also call, first of all they can call international numerals, they can also call Indo-Arabic numerals, and one more name is Hindu Arabic numerals. So the numbers which we are using are called international numerals or Indo-Arabic numerals or Hindu Arabic numerals. Fine. See, we are using some digits, we are using some symbols which are called digits. Same way Romans are also using some symbols. How many symbols Romans are using? Romans are using total 7 symbols. I, V, X, L, C, D and M. I stands for 1, V stands for 5, X stands for 10, L stands for 50, C stands for 100, D stands for 500 and M stands for 1000. Once again, I stands for 1, V stands for 5, X stands for 10, L stands for 50, C stands for 100, D stands for 500 and M stands for 1000. We have some rules which you will use in writing Roman numerals. So let's start with the rules. So rule number one is, the basic 7 symbols can be used in different combination involving addition or subtraction to form numbers. See, if I write I'm writing I two times. This means I am adding both the numerals. This I stands for 1 and again this I stands for 1. Now 1 plus 1 is 2, means this stands for 2. You know your classes also, you have seen outside of your classes it is written this. So this means 5, means you are in 5th standard. If it is written like this, means you are in 12th standard. So this is first rule. Now second rule is, symbol I, X, C, M can be repeated 3 times at any one given time. Symbols V, L, D can never be repeated. See, if I have to write 3, I will write I. This means 3. But if I have to write 4, I can't write like this. This doesn't mean 4. Why? Because you can't repeat any symbol more than 3 times. So if this means 100, now this means 200 and this means 300, but this doesn't meant 400, because you can't repeat any symbol. So you can only repeat I, X, C and M. You can only repeat these symbols, but you can never repeat V, L, can never repeat.
Why?
See, if I write VV, it means 10, because 5 and 5, 10. Then what is the use of X? If I write LL, LL means one L stands for 50. Again, another L stands for 50. 50 plus 50 will be 100. Then what is the use of C? So that's why these three symbols we will never repeat. We can only repeat these symbols maximum of 3 times. Clear? Now third rule. When the smaller symbol is placed on the right of the bigger symbol, then we will add the symbol. See, if I am writing like this, VI, we all know V stands for 5 and I stands for 1. Which one is bigger? V? V is bigger symbol and I is smaller symbol. So whenever smaller symbol is on right hand side, we will add both the symbols. Means I will add greater and smaller. That's why VI stands for 6. But if the smaller symbol is on left hand side, then I will subtract smaller symbol from greater. So that's why this means 4. If, see, V stands for 5. If I am writing smaller right hand side, means add. If I am writing smaller left hand side, means subtract. Clear? Next. Third and fourth rule I have explained you. Now fifth. Symbol I can be added or subtracted from next two symbols, that is V and